Hello, my name is Ruffin, and I'm a software engineering intern at OSRF, where I've been creating and improving development tools for robotic software through the use of Linux containers. I'm currently a PhD student at the Institute for Robotics and Intelligent Machines at Georgia Tech, under the advisory of Henrik Christensen. My research interests include mobile robotic mapping, with a focus of semantic understanding for advanced SLAM, but has led me to become concerned with repeatable and reproducible research in the field of robotics. Recently, a new project has been formed, named the Open Container Initiative, and is being supported by users and industry leaders around the world to bring open standards to software containers. Containers are nothing new to the Linux community, but the rough complexities in building and using them manually serve to obscure the benefits for the majority of developers. On a high level, containers provide a method to isolate and incorporate a runtime environment. They are similar to a lightweight virtual machine, as the containers have their own process space, their own network interface, and their own permissions. On a low level, it's like chroot on steroids, as they share the same kernel with the host and do not rely on device emulation. As processes are isolated but execute on the host, native CPU performance can be achieved, along with additional gains in memory usage and network speeds over traditional virtual machines. The rapid growth and development of projects such as Docker have provoked a widespread interest in the more formal, open specification for building, running, and shipping containers, enabling repeatable, reproducible, and deployable R&D. Robotic software remains an open challenge for research, industry, and education. By leveraging development and shipping tools built around the Open Container Project, roboticists are in a position to gain much in the way of R&D software, thanks in part to the web development community. Again, Linux containers provide a layer of abstraction and automation of operating system-level virtualization, allowing complex applications to remain portable and isolated while maintaining bare metal performance. Over the summer, I worked to incorporate Docker tools into the robotics ecosystem by publishing images for both the ROS1 and Gazebo projects at OSRF within DockerHub's official library registry. Along with this includes the backend machinery to automate and maintain the official images at OSRF. Users can leverage this to define their own templates and auto-generate custom Docker files used to build ROS and Gazebo-enabled images. In addition, I've begun documenting ways to run and deploy ROS and Gazebo applications using the growing collection of Docker tools via the Wiki entries and video demos. Tutorials include linking containers across virtual networks for multi-host distribution, mounting additional hardware such as NVIDIA GPUs, or forwarding Unix sockets for use of graphical applications such as RViz and GZ Client within containers. Also published are automated repositories used to continuously build and distribute the latest developing projects, such as ROS2 and experimental versions of Gazebo. This is especially useful for members of the community who'd like to become involved with the latest developments of the project, but are not yet build experts or wish not to break their current system with conflicting dependencies. In this way, we can lower the barrier to entry for the greater community to test experimental features and provide necessary feedback. This includes build farm images used for the cross-compilation of the ROS1 project. Instruction set emulation for the target architecture is baked inside the slave image for the ROS1's second generation build farm, utilizing Docker and Jenkins. For proof of concept demos using the official image releases described, check out the other posted videos in the links below. And for those attending ROSCon 2015, I hope to meet more of you after my talk on enabling repeatable, reproducible, and deployable robotic software via Linux containers. Lastly, I'd like to thank my mentor, Tully, and all the other folks at OSRF for their awesome support, encouragement, and providing me the opportunity to contribute to the future state of robotic development and deployment tools. Thank you for watching.